Warm welcome to all of you to this interactive session with Mr. N.K. Sinha, Secretary of Culture, and other officers of the Ministry of Culture. Before proceeding to further things, I'd like to introduce the officers seated on the dais. To my immediate left is Mr. Sanjeev Mittal, Joint Secretary in the Ministry of Culture. Next to him is Mr. N.K. Sinha, Secretary of Culture. Then we have Mr. K.K. Mittal, the Additional Secretary of Culture, followed by Srimati Riddhi Mishra, our Deputy Secretary of Culture. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the Ministry of Culture, one of its jobs is to, its mandate is inter alia to conduct the festivals of India abroad. I'll briefly explain the concept of the festivals of India. Now, festivals of India are part of government's focused strategy for strengthening international cultural relations and enhancing India's soft power. The scheme of holding festivals of India was revived in 2013. The events generally included in the festivals of India abroad are dance, music, theater, films festival, food festival, literary festival, yoga festival, folk arts of India, such as Mehndi, artists, exhibitions, lecture demonstrations, workshops, etc. The main focus of a festival of India is to connect and enhance the perception of India in the minds of the locals. Festivals of India, as already indicated, include a number of events which may run concurrently, consecutively, or even over a period in phases. Ministry of Culture's main interlocutors, partners, and executors for conducting the festivals of India are essentially the Indian missions abroad, Indian embassies, high commissions, etc. Now, Ministry of Culture has successfully concluded festivals of India this year in Indonesia, Madagascar, Seychelles, and they are currently ongoing in Malaysia, Mauritius, Korea, Mongolia, Sri Lanka. Festivals of India are in the offing in 2016 in Australia and Myanmar, and we hope in many more, which are at the planning stage. We plan to increase the number of festivals of India to be held annually, gradually. So if we are doing 5 or 6 or 7 right now, we may be doing 10, 12 annually. Now, in order to give impetus to conducting more and more festivals of India abroad, Ministry of Culture has created a Festival of India cell in the ministry to better coordinate and execute the festivals. It is to this end, and to widen the participation of artists and troops, that Ministry of Culture has decided to empanel artists and troops for performing in the festivals. And hence the present calling of applications for empanelments, and hence all of you are here. The meeting with all of you is to invite ideas from the stakeholders, which are yourselves, on how to best portray India's rich cultural heritage abroad. You're all aware that Ministry of Culture advertised in November for inviting applications for empanelment with the Ministry of Culture for giving performances in festivals, and the date was subsequently extended also till 14 December. I must say that the response has been overwhelming. We have over 200 applications received and more are still pouring in, which is very nice for the Ministry of Culture. We, as Ministry of Culture, looks forward to a long association with all of you. And look forward to many more successful festivals of India abroad with all your help. So a very warm welcome once again to all of you. I would now request Shri N.K. Sinha, Secretary Culture, to kindly address the invited guests. Thank you, sir.
आप सबके मन में ये उठ रहा होगा कि ये अचानक क्या परिवर्तन हो रहा है और परिवर्तन आवश्यक है। मैंने जो अपने 6-7 महीने के कार्यकाल में देखा है, मुझे ऐसा लगा कि शायद हम लोग न सिर्फ ट्रांसपेरेंट हों बल्कि ट्रांसपेरेंसी दिखे भी। और भारत कोई इतना छोटा तो है नहीं कि हम 8-10 प्रोग्राम करें अंडर फेस्टिवल ऑफ इंडिया और कहें हमारे यहाँ के सारे कलाकारों का इसमें कवरेज हो गया। भारत विशाल है और हमारे यहाँ का डाइवर्स कल्चर है। फेस्टिवल ऑफ इंडिया सिर्फ वन वे स्ट्रीट नहीं है जहाँ हम जाएं और अपनी कला का प्रदर्शन करें, ये 2-वे स्ट्रीट होना है। हम जिस देश में भी जाएं और अपने सॉफ्ट पावर का प्रदर्शन करें, अपने कल्चर को डिमॉन्स्ट्रेट करें और अपनी सांस्कृतिक विरासत का लोहा मनवाएं, तो वो वन वे तो नहीं होगा। हमें भी उनके कल्चर से कुछ सीखना है और उससे भी ज़्यादा उस देश में हमारे जाने का हमारे देश को क्या फ़ायदा हुआ, हम क्यों उस देश में जा रहे हैं और वहाँ जाके हम अपने साधन स्रोत आपकी प्रतिभा का प्रदर्शन कर रहे हैं तो उससे आपको क्या फ़ायदा हुआ, हमारे देश को क्या फ़ायदा हुआ। ये 2-वे स्ट्रीट होना ही है। अगर ये 2-वे स्ट्रीट नहीं है तो फेस्टिवल ऑफ इंडिया एक महज औपचारिकता रह जाएगी। तो ये काम कैसे किया जाना है? आपका जो उत्साह है, जब हम लोगों ने ये सोचा कि एक शेल्फ ऑफ प्रोग्राम बनाया जाए कि हमारे देश की कौन कौन सी विरासतें, कौन कौन सी सांस्कृतिक कलाएं क्या उपलब्ध है विदेशों में जाके दर्शाए जाने के लिए और उस दर्शाए जाने में कितना कॉस्ट लग रहा है, क्या क्वालिटी है, किस विषय पर है, किस विधा पर है, इन सभी चीज़ों को अगर हम एक जगह सूचीबद्ध कर लेंगे तो हम अपने एम्बेसडर्स को भी कह सकेंगे कि ये चीज़ें आपके लिए उपलब्ध हैं। अब आप बताइए कि उस देश के हिसाब से किन चीज़ों का चयन होना चाहिए। और दूसरा ये भी कि अगर हमारे पास उस विधा में बहुत सारे लोग हैं तो उन लोगों में से समानता का सिद्धांत रखते हुए सेम कैटेगरी होने पर सबों को मौका मिलना चाहिए। ऐसा भी ना हो कि हमने कहा ठीक है आप नंबर वन हैं आप जाइए और दूसरी बार भी आप ही जाइए और तीसरी बार भी आप ही जाइए, हर बार आप ही जाइए, तो फिर दूसरों को मौका कहाँ से मिलेगा। एक बार जरूर जाइए लेकिन दूसरों को भी आगे आना पड़ेगा। हमारी संस्कृति सिर्फ एक अकेले के बस से तो नहीं चलती। तो आशा यही की गई थी कि हम एक इक्विटेबल और ट्रांसपेरेंट, रादर मोर ट्रांसपेरेंट सिस्टम डेवलप करें और इसीलिए समाचार पत्रों के माध्यम से ये विज्ञापन दिया गया था। लेकिन इसमें स्टेक होल्डर्स हम सब हैं, आप हैं, देश है, संस्कृति मंत्रालय है। तो जब हम कुछ नया करने की सोच रहे हैं और एक बहुत बड़ा नया पॉइंट ये है कि अब तक हम लोग 2-4-6 देशों में फेस्टिवल ऑफ इंडिया किया करते थे, जैसा कि अभी आपको इंट्रोडक्शन में बताया गया कि 4-5 देश हैं जहां ऐसा हो रहा है और 2016 के लिए प्लान्ड है। हम लोगों ने ये सोचा कि इतने से तो काम नहीं चलेगा, इतने से भारतीय संस्कृति को अगर विश्व के स्तर पर स्थापित करना है, दिखाना है कि हम क्या हैं, तो हमारे 190 के करीब देश हैं, हम कब तक करते रहेंगे? अगर 4 के हिसाब से किया हमने तो 50 साल लगेंगे। तब तक में तो जिन चार में हमने कुछ भी काम किया था वो भी भूल जाएंगे, तो ऐसे काम नहीं चलेगा। तो ये कन्वर्जेंस होना चाहिए हमारे देश के हितों का, हमारी संस्कृति के विस्तार का, हम अपने संस्कृति को और देशों तक पहुंचाएं। इसलिए हम लोगों ने ये कोशिश की है कि आने वाले 2016 साल से ये संख्या सीमित नहीं रखी जाए, जहां से भी हमें अच्छे प्रस्ताव मिलते हैं और देश को ये लगता है कि हाँ यहाँ हमें अपनी प्रतिभा का प्रदर्शन करना चाहिए, वहाँ को हम चुनें। तो ये जो पहले का एक लिमिट था 4, 5, 10, वो हम लोग नहीं चाहते कि बस इसी लिमिट पर हम लोग रहें और इतना ही काम करके हम अपनी पीठ थपथपा लें कि हमने बहुत कर दिया। इसलिए बजट की भी व्यवस्था की जा रही है और अब वो समय आ गया है कि हम लोग एक विस्तृत शेल्फ ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट्स बनाएं और उसको फ्लोट करें अपने एम्बेसडर्स के पास। ये सब अवेलेबल है, आप अपनी प्राथमिकताओं को देखिए और कहिए आपको क्या चाहिए, और जहां से हमें टैंजिबल आउटकम की उम्मीद हो उसे हम सेलेक्ट कर लें। तो आज की बैठक, चूंकि हमने एक ऐड दिया था, बहुत छोटा था, हालांकि उसमें लिखा था कि डिटेल्स होंगे वेबसाइट पर, और हमने सोचा था कि कुछ लोगों तक ये खबर पहुंचेगी, 20, 25, 40, 50 तक एप्लीकेशन आएंगे जिनको ये खबर मिल पाई। लेकिन जब ये एप्लीकेशन 200 के लगभग आए तो मुझे लगा कि नहीं, इस ग्रुप में भी एक अवेयरनेस है और ये देश के लिए कुछ करना चाहते हैं। तो फिर मैंने कहा तुरंत में बैठक बुलाइए, इन सब की मदद से हम लोग एक प्लान ऑफ एक्शन बनाएं और आगे बढ़ें। इसलिए आज आपको कष्ट दिया गया। हम लोगों ने यह भी कोशिश की है कि आज हम लोग जो कुछ भी कर रहे हैं इसका वेबकास्ट हो और इसकी रिकॉर्डिंग फिर YouTube पर डाली जाए, ताकि जो लोग यहाँ नहीं आ पाए उन्हें भी इस बारे में जानकारी मिले और वो भी इस जो अभियान है इसमें जुड़ें। तो मुझे इससे ज़्यादा कुछ नहीं कहना, मुझे बल्कि आपसे सुनना है कि कैसे हम लोग इस प्रक्रिया को और पारदर्शी बनाएं और कैसे हम कुछ ऐसा करें कि विश्व के पटल पर भारत की एक अमिट सांस्कृतिक छाप हम छोड़ सकें। इसलिए आपके सुझाव आमंत्रित हैं, आपकी मदद से ही ये कार्यक्रम आगे चलेगा और इसका कृपया प्रचार प्रसार कीजिए, अपने और लोगों को भी बताइए। ये एक्सक्लूजन प्रिंसिपल पर नहीं चलना चाहिए कि मुझे मालूम हो गया अब औरों को ना मालूम हो, तो फिर देश की संस्कृति आगे नहीं बढ़ेगी। सबों को बताइए, लोगों को आने दीजिए, जहां प्रतिभा है उस प्रतिभा को पहचानने के भी उपाय हम आपसे ही पूछेंगे। अगर एक किसी विधा में 10 लोगों ने अपने नाम दिए तो हम आपसे क्या चाहेंगे, उसका कुछ सैंपल होना चाहिए, आपकी कॉस्टिंग होनी चाहिए और कुछ ऐसा होना चाहिए कि उन 10 में पहले कौन जाएं। अगर सबका स्तर एक है, सपोज सबके सब एक स्तर के हैं, तो कहीं ना कहीं जाएंगे। ये तो मुझे दिख रहा है, जब नंबर बढ़ेंगे देशों के जहां हमारे फेस्टिवल ऑफ इंडिया हों तो 10 के 10 भी जा सकते हैं, लेकिन पहले कौन जाए। और या तो एक रोस्टर की तरह बने कि ठीक है अगला जो भी कार्यक्रम होगा वो आप रोस्टर पर हैं आप जाइए, फिर यह पिक एंड चूज नहीं होगा कि अच्छा यूएसए में जाना है तो हम जाएं, तो वो भी नहीं होना चाहिए। पारदर्शिता का मतलब यही है कि हम किसी को फेवर ना करें लेकिन पूरे देश के लिए सब लोग मिलकर काम करें। तो अब आपके सुझाव आमंत्रित हैं, अगर कुछ और परिवर्तन की आवश्यकता है तो भी आप बताइए। ये एक तरह से ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग सेशन है और अगर बाद में भी किन्हीं को कोई सुझाव देने हैं तो वो दें, ताकि जब तक हम इसको क्रिस्टलाइज कर दें, अगले साल का पूरा प्लान ऑफ एक्शन बना दें, तब तक जो भी सुझाव आते हैं हम उन सुझावों पर कम से कम विचार कर लें और अगर ज़रूरत पड़ी तो ऐसी बैठक एक और कर लें। इससे ज़्यादा मुझे नहीं कहना है, बस हम लोग अब इंटरैक्शन के लिए तैयार हैं, आपके सुझाव आमंत्रित हैं। धन्यवाद। जय हिंद।
Before we start with the question answers, I'll request whoever is asking the question, please identify yourself and also your organization so that we can take appropriate notes, and thank you.
Hello, sir. Very good evening, and thank you so much for initiating such a, I think, splendid talk with we all. Myself, Dinesh Yadav. You want me to come? Okay. हेलो सर दोस्तों मेरा नाम दिनेश यादव है मैं स्वयंभू फाउंडेशन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन न्यू दिल्ली से हूँ बट फाउंडेशन हिंदुस्तान के लगभग 6 बड़े स्टेट्स में काम करता है मैं ये देख रहा था कि पिछले लगभग मैं नेशनल स्क्रिप्ट ड्रामा से 2007 में पास आउट हूँ उसके बाद मैं लंदन अकेडमी ऑफ म्यूजिक एंड ड्रामेटिक आर्ट्स लामडा से 2010 में पास आउट हूँ ये मेरा बैकग्राउंड है प्रेजेंटली आई एम and contractual assistant professor in BITS Pilani, Pilani campus. That's what my job is. मेरा पिछले लगभग 10 साल का ये experience रहा है हिंदुस्तान के बाहर कुछ 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 देशों में जा कर के काम करने का और काम देखने का कि majorly what we are known for are traditional art. लेकिन हम लोग लैक करते हैं कि जहाँ कहीं कंटेम्प्रेरी परफॉर्मेंस हो रही होती है या कंटेम्प्रेरी लेवल का कोई काम हो रहा होता है वहाँ पे हम जनरली मात खा जाते हैं तो या तो हमारे बहुत ट्रेडिशनल डांस फॉर्म्स जा रहे होते हैं या म्यूजिक फॉर्म्स जा रहे हैं जो अपने आप में बहुत कमाल चीज़ है मेरा उसके प्रति कोई विरोधाभास नहीं है लेकिन जैसे मैं कुछ दिन पहले प्राग में एक बहुत कमाल की एग्जीबिशन होती है प्राग क्वाड्रेनल के नाम से विच इज़ हैपनिंग फ्रॉम लास्ट सिंस 67 ईयर्स एंड जिस वर्ल्ड biggest design exhibition majorly for theater ke liye hai aur scenography ke liye architecture ke liye main dekha ki usme hindustan ki taraf se koi pratinidhitv nahi hai to is tarike ke jo contemporary festivals hai bhale chahe wo design ke ho wo theater art ke ho wo music ke ho dance ke ho agar ministry is tarike ke festivals ko ya unke theme ko अपने दृष्टिपटल पर रखें या अपने मानसिक पटल पर रखें तो मुझे लगता है कि हम एक बहुत बड़ा सेक्शन वो भी अचीव कर पाएंगे जो जो हमसे कहीं छूट रहा है ये मेरा मानना है थैंक यू सो मच
आप कोई कॉन्सेप्ट पेपर दे सकते हैं क्योंकि जो आपने कहा वो शायद फेस्टिवल ऑफ इंडिया से डायरेक्टली कवर नहीं हो आइसोलेटेड इंस्टेंसेस में कहीं कहीं ये एग्जीबिशन हो रहे हों तो आपका ये भी कहना होगा कि इंडिया उसमें पार्टिसिपेट करे ताकि लोग वहाँ जाने इंडिया का कंटेम्प्रेरी आर्ट स्टेटस क्या है क्या आप ये चाहते हैं या इसको फेस्टिवल ऑफ इंडिया के अम्ब्रेला के तहत चाहते हैं
दोनों काम हो सकते हैं अगर आप उसको उन फेस्टिवल्स में पार्टिसिपेट करना भी अगर आपको लगता है कि वाजिब चीज़ होगी तो वो भी हो सकता है लेकिन मेरा ये भी मानना है कि इन टर्म्स ऑफ प्रेजेंटेशन जब हम बाहर जा रहे हैं अपना काम लेकर के एज फेस्टिवल ऑफ इंडिया अगर उस वक्त हम अपने आप को कंटेम्प्रेरी मॉडर्न भी रखते हैं एज वेल एज आर ट्रेडिशनल पावर्स तो मुझे लगता है कि हम एक बहुत बड़े जो सेक्शन छूट रहा है उसको और कवर कर पाते
आप एक कॉन्सेप्ट पेपर बनाइए आपके मन में क्या है वो दीजिए कि ये कंटेम्प्रेरी आर्ट कैसे लाया जाए और इसके रिसोर्स पर्सन्स कहाँ से आएँ वो अगर आप दे दें तो हम लोग उनको भी ध्यान में रखने की कोशिश करेंगे उधर
थैंक यू सर
नमस्कार मेरा नाम गार्गी सेठ है और 15 साल से मैं एक कंटेम्प्रेरी आर्ट क्यूरेटर हूँ और मैं एक बार फिर मैं भी ये कहना चाहूँगी कि ये डिस्कशन बहुत ज़रूरी और बहुत ही एप्ट है इस टाइम के लिए जो मिस्टर यादव ने कहा उसके लिए मैं ये कहना चाहूँगी कि हर संस्कृति अपने इतिहास और अपने क्लासिकल आर्ट फॉर्म्स को अलाइव रखना चाहती है और हर संस्कृति अगर आप देखेंगे तो जो कंटेम्प्रेरी भी है उसका फाउंडेशन जो है वो क्लासिकल और जो चीज़ें टाइम इमेमोरियल से रखी जाती हैं हर संस्कृति में उसी को फाउंडेशन लेके और उसके ऊपर कंटेम्प्रेराइज किया जाता है जो मैंने प्रपोजल सबमिट किया था उसमें मेरा प्रपोजल भी कुछ ऐसा ही था कि इंडिया के जो एपिक्स हैं क्योंकि आप देखेंगे कि भारत में कहीं भी कला है तो उसमें डिवाइन को सर्च करने की या यू नो ये ज़रूर हमेशा चाहे आप मधुबनी पेंटिंग्स ले लीजिए चाहे रागमाला पेंटिंग्स ले लीजिए डिवाइन को या गॉड को सर्च करना या उसके साथ अपनी रिलेशनशिप को सर्च करना ये भारतीय कला में पुराने समय से लेकर और इवन आज की तारीख में भी जो कंटेम्प्रेरी आर्टिस्ट हैं वो इस चीज़ को ज़रूर अपने प्रैक्टिस में कहीं ना कहीं लेकर आते हैं. तो मेरा सुझाव ये था कि जो फेस्टिवल ऑफ इंडिया के अंतर्गत ही हम एक कंटेम्प्रेरी आर्ट एग्जिबिशन लेके जाएं, जिसमें कि इंडिया के जाने माने कंटेम्प्रेरी आर्टिस्ट को आमंत्रित करके और उनसे स्पेशली कहा जाए कि वो अपना ऐसा काम उसके लिए दें जिसमें उन्होंने इंडियन एपिक्स को अपने कंटेम्प्रेरी वे में रीइंटरप्रेट करके प्रेजेंट किया हो, जिससे ना सिर्फ कंटेम्प्रेरी प्लेटफॉर्म पे इंडिया की एक पहचान बनेगी बल्कि हमारा जो हमारी स्ट्रेंथ है जो कि हमारे क्लासिक्स हैं, हमारे एपिक्स हैं, उनका भी एक वर्चस्व होगा, उनका भी फैलाव होगा.
हाँ, अच्छा सुझाव है. और क्या ललित कला एकेडमी इसमें कुछ आगे लेगा रोल या कौन करेंगे, इसका कोऑर्डिनेशन किसके पास होगा?
सर, बेसिकली फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट व्हेन वी विल हैव द शेल्फ ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट्स, देन एज पर द डिस्कशन जी एज पर द डिस्कशन विद द एम्बेसडर वट एवर इज रिक्वायर्ड. बट वट आई फील इज दैट देर इज ए लॉट ऑफ डिमांड एंड lot of work can be done with our another scheme wherein we allow the individual artists to participate abroad in some organized fairs and festivals which are initiative of those countries and in which various Indian artists participate, and we have a scheme of reimbursing their travel expenses, slightly reorienting that scheme. In Dalit Kala Academy also we are having that scheme, we have newly introduced it. So we have slightly elaborated it that it can be either traveling allowance of the artist or it can be the traveling expenses of the artwork which he is carrying, the maximum limit being 1 lakh. So many a times the artists find that their travel is being taken care of, but the taking their whole troupe or the accompanist will require money. So if that flexibility is given, I think that many of the artists and many of the things which we have heard from the earlier two, because where suppose Prague, that is not an initiative of Government of India or Ambassador, that is a structured Prague festival which goes on there. And there many artists participate and they get the individual invitation also, that you can come individually, they take up and they get the individual invitation. At that time, they face the difficulty of meeting the expenditures, which is there for participating in such type of exhibition. So there is another scheme of ours, which is on our website, wherein we promote individual participation of the artist and the art exhibition abroad, if they go there. There also, if you want, you can just comment on that scheme also, how we can just tweak with that scheme, whether certain changes are required in that scheme. Because many of the problem or many of the discussions which we are having, I think that we can take care of from that scheme also.
Good afternoon, sir. I'm Ananda Shankar Jayant from Hyderabad. I'm from the 87 batch of the railways, but that's one part of my life. The other life is I'm a dancer. I'm a Bharatnatyam and Kuchipudi dancer. A Padma awardee and a Sangeet Natak Academy awardee. And I have a society which runs, which has an institution which has classical dance of both Bharatnatyam and Kuchipudi. So at the outset, allow me to congratulate the ministry for having this fantastic gathering of minds of all of you to share our views from the other side, as it were. It's fantastic that you're thinking of the roster which we have been requesting for some time now, because I think a roster will really ease out angst and agony of the artists of, you know, not being repeated. Having said that, I would like to take on from what the earlier artists have spoken. I think the first artist was talking about trying to see how we can integrate into existing international festivals, big ticket festivals. And that I think can happen if we could plan ahead, because these festivals are usually planned years ahead, at least a year and a half ahead. Like for instance, the Festival of India, I mean the festivals in China or Hong Kong or Korea or something like that, which are planned ahead. So that way the artist goes beyond the Festival of India itself, which is one level, and then goes to being part of the international performing or presentation group. So that's one suggestion that we plan ahead. The second suggestion is, sir, that for the last few festivals that we have been watching, pardon me, but it seems like collages by colleges. A lot of collage, work by the colleges maintained by and supported by the ministry, which is fantastic because the youngsters, the amateurs get a great chance. But at the end of the day, I think Indian art is more than that, more than just that little bit, as you rightly said. And I think if that can be focused upon, then we have a larger mosaic to present. And the fourth point I'd like to leave with is if we can tailor festivals to suit particular themes so that it just doesn't become, as I said, collages of colleges, so that we can have more interesting ideas emanating, specially curated, specially commissioned work. And if for all this, we would need to start ahead, to time ahead. And if you can also, going to Mr. Mittal, if you can also look at travel grants for artists who might be selected outside the Festival of India for international festivals and allow them to travel and perform. So that I think you can represent them on multiple levels. Thank you very much.
Saransh Kanoja, International Devaparivar Society, National Coordinator. एक चीज जैसे सर ने स्टार्टिंग में कहा था कि वो रिसोर्स पर्संस कहाँ से आएंगे अगर कुछ भी हम करना चाहते हैं एक्स्ट्रा तो सर हमने अपने यहाँ पे कोशिश की है कि इंडियन फोक डांस और म्यूज़िक के जो डिफरेंट पर्संस हैं जिनको अभी तक कोई स्टेज नहीं मिला है उनको हम कर सकें अगर इस तरीके कोई कल्चरल मिनिस्ट्री करता है कि इंडिया गॉट टैलेंट टाइप से क्योंकि क्या है कि एक तो हमारा एम है कि भारतीय संस्कृति को विदेशों में लेके जाना लेकिन अगर नए कुछ लोगों को भी मौका मिलता है जिनके पास टैलेंट है तो मुझे लगता है वो ज़्यादा अच्छा हो सकता है लाइक इंडिया गॉट टैलेंट टाइप समथिंग अगर हम ऑर्गेनाइज करते हैं इंडिया के अंदर टैलेंट सर्च के लिए
अच्छा आइडिया है लेकिन जिस स्केल पर इंडिया गॉट टैलेंट होता है अगर उसके 10,000 गुना बड़े स्केल पर हम लोग करना चाहें तो आपका क्या ख्याल है कैसे करें हर गांव में हर साल टैलेंट की खोज हो
जी सर
इसका कोई मैकेनिज्म है तो आप बनाएं और अपने आइडियाज़ भेजें
सर
तो इंडिया गॉट टैलेंट अगर
जी सर
20 25 30 शहरों में होता है ये 6.5 लाख गांव में होना है कैसे करेंगे आइडियाज़ दीजिए हम लोग कुछ काम करें
सर मैं वैसे तो अपने पास 20 स्टेट्स के रिप्रेजेंटेटिव हैं जो आर्ट और डांस पे करते हैं बाकी डिटेल मैं आपको फिर बाद में इसके हिसाब से बना के देता हूँ थैंक यू
गुड इवनिंग लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन आई एम शांति मजुमदार आई एम स्टेइंग इन दिल्ली फॉर द लास्ट 20 इयर्स बट आई ग्रेजुएटेड फ्रॉम शांतिनिकेतन यू नो द यूनिवर्सिटी सेटअप बाय Rabindranath Tagore. Since I studied in Shantinikatan, I got a chance very closely to see the rich cultural heritage which was imbibed by Rabindranath Tagore. Apart from that, I have a troupe consisting of about 10 persons, 10 artists, female, male singer, dancer, makeup man and 5 musicians. So we have been presenting the cultural programs in India as well. I got a chance to visit Adelaide 2 years back and in Adelaide they celebrate the India Day. And on that day I got a chance to present my troupe who presented Bengali, Hindi, Punjabi, and Assamese dances and songs. I must congratulate Minister of Culture for developing this idea. And in that respect, as Mr. Sinha rightly said, that India is a vast country with a diverse cultural heritage. Similarly, when the Minister of Culture is selecting some country to send our troop, I think the most priority thing they should consider is to project our rich cultural heritage. Now, from east to west and north to south, if we can develop the cultural heritage in those regions and try to project this heritage and these cultural programs in outside country, then I think the foreign countries, they will get to know what we are. And in cultural field, what is our contribution? For that, it is not a 1 or 2 days job, but we have to see. But basically, we have to find out that which country we are going. And in that country, which cultural programs from which site, whether it is north, south, east and west, we would like to present that one. And if we can pinpoint that program, I think it is very easy for so many talents sitting here to develop the program. That is my suggestion.
Namaskar everyone. My name is Shantanu Das. I'm coming from Kolkata. Actually, I'm teaching over there. There is a small university called Ravindra Bharati University. And I'm passed out from National School of Drama and teaching over there. I have a small theater group. What about the Festival of India? I have seen in Bhutan and I have an opportunity to go there. It's okay. But I have a suggestion and in my mind that you are talking about the two-way things. So is there any possibilities to make out a collaborative project, like as we are theater practitioner, I'm doing theater in Kolkata. And if, quote unquote, that's you are talking about the next is in Australia. Their theater groups, some artists from them, or some artists from our, meeting together, doing some work and presenting that. I don't know. Is there any possibilities incorporate these things in the Festival of India? I don't know. Sort of a collaborative project. Maybe it is possible in the dance also, I think. Definitely, it's very possible. It's not only theater. So it is a suggestion, that's it. Otherwise, the whole thing is absolutely fine. The dancers, folk dancers, musicians, everyone is going and participating. There are things, that's it.
See, I think the idea is good, but this idea may be quite expensive.
Yeah.
People from India having a tie-up with people in that country and then trying to do something together, which will either mean that your troop goes there, stays for a long period of time, or they come here and stay for a long period of time, or you have some kind of a video link and then you are practicing. But even then, the finesse will come only when you perform together.
Correct.
You do the rehearsals and practices together. So that you may propose, but perhaps on the cost front, it will exceed the limits. Otherwise, if you are having collaborations and there is some opportunity coming your way, we will be very happy. Because we have to. Nothing happens. If you go to a foreign country and perform and come back, you may be remembered for 1 month, 2 months, six
yeah.
months. But if people, local artists from that area are involved,
yeah.
they will keep your flame alive for a much longer time. So while we agree in principle that this should happen, how it should happen, within what cost parameters, we have to examine and you can give your suggestions.
Thank you, sir.
Respected secretary, deputy secretaries, joint secretary, I'm Sonia Sharma from Dhyan Foundation. We are a not-for-profit organization working with the primary objective of spreading the correct awareness of yoga. Yoga as it was practiced thousands of years back by our ancient masters. It is not limited to only asanas and pranayams. Yoga was documented by Rishi Patanjali about 5,000 years ago, and it encompasses eight limbs, the Ashtanga Yoga. So my submission here is that although, of course, there is a lot of recognition worldwide about our soft power as the originators of yoga, the pristine sciences, when our prime minister says, let's have an international day on yoga, then millions of people across from New York to China come out on the streets to practice yoga. What I'd like to highlight is that, as I said, yoga has eight limbs, and asanas and pranayams is limiting our own subject to only a physical exercise. I would like to bring out that I'm myself a chartered accountant. I was working with the biggest CA firm in London, and I had the good fortune of meeting Yogi Ashwini, the guiding light of Dhyan Foundation, at an event organized by the Nehru Commission, the Nehru Center, by the High Commission of London. And after searching across religions, across cultures, everything, I'd been living there for 15 years, I finally found my answers in the Indian Vedic sciences, as is taught to me by my guru. And it's my burning desire that millions of Indians and non-Indians worldwide who are soul-searching can extremely kind of benefit so much out of understanding the true essence of Vedic culture and sciences. And my submission is that if I could work with the Ministry of Culture, if we could work together to bring out the subtler aspects of our Vedic sciences, like the power of mantras, the vibrations that they create, it can create world harmony actually. The power of our yajnas, the Vedic sciences, what is the energy of sun, what is the energy of moon, how our ancient masters were accessing it. And all of this is possible in today's day and age also. At Dhyan Foundation, we are practicing it. Most of the people are educated people working in IBM or running their own training programs, everything. I mean, very highly intellectual society is hooking on to this idea because we are seeing the efficacy of these sciences. And that's what I'd like to bring out.
Yeah, this is a good idea. In fact, we are also working on bringing out what knowledge we can extract from Vedas,
yes,
and our ancient heritage and also our manuscripts. That mission is on. So whoever wants to contribute, they are most welcome.
So how do we go about, what would be the next step? How do we start actually taking action on this, working together?
You can submit a concept note which we will go through and then pass it on to the mission concerned. They will get in touch with you. The mission is running, I think, in IGNCA, Indira Gandhi National Center for Art. We have a manuscript mission. We have a website on a Vedic portal. We have those things where our scholars are working. You may join those scholars and enrich their experiences and bring out something which is good for the nation.
Hello. My name is Kishab Kanti Chaudhary. I am a tabla maestro and I play different types of percussions. And I have a music society in the name of Sangeetika Music Society. And we are some artists, we are performing together. And my main focus is on Indian ethnic percussions. And I have worked in Jawaharlal Nehru Cultural Center, Embassy of India, Russia, and Indian Cultural Center, Tanzania, and I have done freelancing in Europe, Spain. And I have, so far, I have not seen different types of percussions which India should project in other countries. Jaise amare India mein bahut tarah ka percussions hai, ethnic percussion. In each state, we have different types of percussions. तो हमने मॉस्को में देखा था जो फेस्टिवल ऑफ इंडिया हुआ वहाँ हमने कोई हमारा परकशंस को कोई फोकस नहीं करते जैसे वहाँ में नहीं देखा फिर तंजानिया में भी हमने ऐसे कुछ नहीं देखा तो मेरा ये एक सजेशन है हमारा जो इतनी पुरानी जो साजे है डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ परकशंस जो हाथ से बजाने वाला जो वाद्य है तो उसको भी थोड़ा फोकस किया जाए और हमारा जो ग्रुप है हम वी आर फोर आर्टिस्ट एंड आई प्ले डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ परकशंस एज वेल एज जल तरंग एंड तबला तरंग व्हिच यूज्ड टू बी इन यूज वेरी अर्ली डेज एंड नाउ नाउ इट इज गोइंग टू बी एक्सटिंक्ट
जो चीज़ हमारा ऑलमोस्ट एक्सटेंड होने जा रहा है, ये हमारा गवर्नमेंट मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कल्चर शूड प्रमोट इट, इसको भी थोड़ा सा हाईलाइट करना चाहिए। जैसे जल तरंग बहुत कम सुनने को लिए मिलता है, तबला तरंग इट्स ऑलरेडी वेनिश्ड। तो ये मेरा सजेशन है कि जो हमारा एथनिक परकशंस को थोड़ा सा प्रमोट किया जाए। थैंक यू वेरी मच।
यह आपका सेशन बड़ा अच्छा है, इसमें अगर कोई ग्रुप सामने आए, हमारे सामने आए और हमें अपनी प्रपोजल भेजे, तो हम डेफिनेटली उसे भी कोशिश करेंगे कि फेस्टिवल ऑफ इंडिया में इंक्लूड किया जाए। आपने सबमिट किया तो उसके ऊपर बाकायदा विचार किया जाएगा।
गुड इवनिंग सर, या जस्ट वन रिक्वेस्ट। गुड इवनिंग, माय नेम इज़ कुमुद दीवान, आई एम हिंदुस्तानी क्लासिकल वोकलिस्ट। Something which I'm going to request to all of you present here today, the Honorable Secretary Sir and Additional Secretary Sir and Joint Secretary Sir, essentially I think it echoes the sentiments of all the established artists of the country, that in any festival of India which we handle, either through our nodal agencies, Sangeet Natak, IGNC, etc., or through the ministries, AGs, which used to be handled by the ICCR previously, it's very important for us, artist fraternity and community, that the selection criteria is very objective and very objectively applied. And in the selection criteria, you can consider the gradations of Doordarshan for dance and the gradations of All India Radio for music, which are above board and acceptable everywhere as a gradation criteria. Also, probably the ICCR gradation, which is of the three categories in which artists are graded on the basis of their performances in the videos and periodically upgraded while they are empaneled. Also important in this direction is because to keep this not only the selection criteria objective and therefore fair, it's also very important that how many times who has gone for the festival in the last 15 years, because ICCR has the data on that. And we know that for the last 10-15 years that we are empaneled and working, that in every festival of India, the same dancers and the same musicians end up going for some reason or the other. And I'm not denying they could be the topmost musicians of this country, and that's a very, very nice thing. But there are other musicians who are not less capable than that. And I have the courage to stand up here in front of all of you and request Secretary Sir very politely that the objective criteria for selection must be applied either on the basis of the gradation which is already given by All India Radio and Doordarshan, and also historical data to be taken from the ICCR as to who has gone to which festival in the last, say, 10 years, either solo artists or their groups. Take a decade, 10-year cutoff, and you'll automatically see that somebody has gone 7 times and somebody has got, if you get the data from ICCR, these blips are going to show very, very clearly. And let's, now that this has come to a centralized cell in the ministry, which we are very happy about, sir, I hope these individual interpretations at the nodal agency level or at the official level of the agencies will not surpass the actual criteria which should be applicable. That's a very, very humble suggestion, and that's the only request that I want to.
One suggestion I would like to. This is an international model where you are empaneled on different lists, and marks are allotted, and there is one final list. Something like that could be made, because most of us are ICCR outstanding artists, established artists, Doordarshan outstanding artists, Sangeet Natak Academy awardees, Padma awardees. So I think some kind of marking can be made so that you have a roster that can be created transparently.
Idea is about giving weightages to different recognitions should also be given. So who to be given how much weight? Somebody will say, I am a Padma awardee, so 10 out of 10. Now somebody says, I am A grade Doordarshan, so how many marks? Ultimately, a plethora of grading criteria are to be added. So we have to have a weighted average of that. How to do that? Please send suggestions. This was one of the reasons I did not mention, because it touches some raw nerves. I did not mention, but now that it has been mentioned, how do we grade people? And then whatever we come out with, we'll put it on the web. So everybody knows who is where, and who is in what list and who is at what point in the roster.
Namaskar. Mera naam Smita Nagdev hai. Main Bhopal se aayi hu aur main pichle kai saalon se sitar ke performance de rahi hu all over world. To mera sirf ye kehna hai ki main Bhopal mein rehti hu. Ye pehli baar hua ki mujhe pata pada ki is tarah ka kuch ho raha hai. To aapki taraf se Ministry of Culture se aisa hona chahiye ki jo dusre jo rajya hain un tak bhi khabar pahunche. Abhi tak ye hum logon tak khabar nahi pahunchi. Main pichle 15 saalon se duniya bhar mein jo bhi karyakram kar rahi hu wahin se ek karyakram hua uske marfat dusra kisi ne pasand kiya aur unhone kaha ki aap fir aaye aise karke France Europe America Singapore aur China kafi baar mujhe bulaya gaya. To aap log aisa kuch plan kare ki jo dusre rajya mein bhi jo प्रतिभाएं हैं उन्हें भी मौका मिले और जैसा इन्होंने कहा और आपने कहा कि एक जो ग्रेडेशन के बेस पर जो आप भेजेंगे वो बिल्कुल होना ही चाहिए तो हम लोग जो टॉप मोस्ट आर्टिस्ट हैं उनके बाद के जो पीढ़ी है या उनके बाद के लेवल के लोग हैं उनके लिए भी आप उसकी या तो लिस्ट आप लोग तैयार करें उनके परफॉर्मेंसेस के बेसिस पे जैसा ICCR के पास है उसको ही एक कैटेगराइज करते हुए अगर आप आर्टिस्ट भेजते हैं मैं सोलो परफॉर्मर हूं तो मुझे कई बार बुलाया जाता है और एक ये भी बहुत यूरोपियन कंट्रीज में खासकर ये है कि महिला सितार वादक बहुत कम हैं और उनके लिए बड़ी बात हो जाती है तो वो हमें बुलाते हैं पर हम लोगों तक ये खबर पहुंचना चाहिए दूसरे शहरों में और हम लोग अपने राज्यों में रह के काफ़ी हद तक के कोशिश में लगे रहते हैं और बाहर जो लोग भेजे जाते हैं उनको ना सिर्फ संगीत के लिए लेकिन वो पूरे भारत के प्रतिनिधि हो जाते हैं जब वो बाहर जाते हैं सिर्फ संगीतकार नहीं तो ऐसे लोगों का भी चयन होना चाहिए जो हमारे देश को का प्रतिनिधित्व उस लेवल पे कर सकें ऐसा नहीं हो कि आपने भेजे हैं और कभी कुछ बहुत नेगेटिव बातें भी खुल के आती हैं या हम भी सुनते हैं कि आपके यहाँ से लोग आए और ऐसा हुआ तो इस तरह का भी आपको कुछ उसके मापदंड तय करना होंगे मुझे ऐसा लगता है धन्यवाद
दिस इज संध्या पुरीचा फ्रॉम मुंबई आई एम अ प्रिंसिपल ऑफ भरत कॉलेज ऑफ फाइन आर्ट एंड कल्चर भरतनाट्यम एक्सपोनेंट आपने जो कहा कल्चरल एक्सचेंज तो सिर्फ परफॉर्मेंस करके कल्चरल एक्सचेंज करने से बजाय वहाँ के कॉलेजेस या तो स्कूल से कोऑर्डिनेट करके वहाँ वर्कशॉप सेमिनार्स हमारे प्रोग्राम्स के बारे में अगर कि जैसे हम एडिनबरा फेस्टिवल में अगर आप परफॉर्म करने जाते हो तो कंपलसरी है कि वहाँ की चार स्कूलों में आप जाके अपने उनके बच्चों को कुछ सिखाएँ और वो उनके जो डांस टीचर या म्यूज़िक टीचर है वो आपका जो ग्रुप गया होता है उनको वो कल्चरल एक्सचेंज करवाते हैं तो दैट शुड बी अ पार्ट ऑफ कल्चरल एक्सचेंज प्रोग्राम आई फील इट इफ यू फील इट
नमस्कार मेरा नाम स्वप्निल वर्मा है मैं एक ठुमरी सिंगर हूँ और विदुषी सविता देवी जी की शिष्या हूँ मैं पूरब अंग गायकी से जुड़ी हुई हूँ और गाती हूँ और इसे सिखाती भी हूँ तो पूरब अंग गायकी जो है वो फोक और क्लासिकल का सबसे सुंदर मिश्रण है मुझे लगता है लेकिन इसका प्रचार प्रसार इतना नहीं है जितना होना चाहिए पहले तो बहुत ज़्यादा था और इसके अंतर्गत ठुमरी दादरा होरी चैती कजरी इत्यादि गाई जाती हैं तो मुझे लगता है कि फेस्टिवल ऑफ इंडिया में ठुमरी के ज़्यादा प्रोग्राम्स होने चाहिए ज़्यादा इसको प्रमोट करना चाहिए हमें और इसके अलावा जैसे कि इन्होंने भी बोला कि वर्कशॉप्स भी होने चाहिए ताकि ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा लोग इसे सीख सकें क्योंकि इसे सीखने वाले लोग अब बहुत ही कम रह गए हैं तो मुझे लगता है इसके वर्कशॉप्स कंडक्ट करनी चाहिए ठुमरी की
आई एम सुधीर शर्मा फ्रॉम रोहतक हरियाणा आई एम अ फोकलोरिस्ट फ्रॉम दैट प्लेस आई'ड लाइक टू एम्फेसाइज दैट द फोक परफॉर्मर्स not only in Haryana but in Punjab western UP Delhi and other places too should be given importance they have not been much exposed in spite of the fact that they are keeping the old tradition of ballad singing alive I've come across people who sing for 10 to 12 days continuously in the evenings of course there are very few countries in the world where ballad singing is still popular and it is popular in this area the resource person of CCRT for Haryana and have recently completed a film on the Jogi singers of Haryana. They're not only of Haryana, but of adjacent places. These people are not only singers, they are good narrators, and they are also dancers. And they play on their folk instruments like the sarangi, the deru, the bapang, the bell, and so on. So we have not treated them as performers, but only as mendicant singers. So my submission is that these people, not only in this state or elsewhere, they should be given due importance in the calendar of things. Secondly, I endorse the view that we must have workshops. These people are invited only for performances. Like at the Suraj Kund Mela, two people playing on the sarangi. Why they do it? What is the background? What are the tales that they sing? What is the importance of it? And how we can incorporate these things in the educational system and other systems. I hope this would be taken care of. Thank you very much.
I'm Jayachandran Palari, Artistic Director of Art Culinary Center for Movement Arts, which is the most important contemporary dance organization in the country, around 50 people working and around 1,000 students. And we have a festival, this one, which runs for 10 days in multiple venues in Bangalore. And that there is workshops, there is residencies, we produce work of young choreographers. We also have a writing on dance workshop, which is to aim to develop the critical analysis of performance. And we also have, apart from commissioning work, we also curate work from all over India, but also from 25 different countries. So this is a major international festival where we have partnership with the European Dance House Network, with Korea, with Japan, with the Scandinavian countries, Australia. So we have cultivated this over the last 15 years, and this is the 15th year of the biennial completed. Now 2017 will be the next biennial. A biennial will take at least 2 years or 3 years to develop the whole concept. Now I would suggest, you know, when such a big thing happens, I would really would like to welcome you to have a look at what is happening, at least one of you, so that you have a direct experience of the whole thing. And I had a brief meeting with Mittal sir, and I just explained to him how we have over the years worked with so many traditional forms, and we have a department of folk and traditional performing arts, and we have developed works, and then these works were categorized and put on a digital platform, which is of a really high international standard. And some of the festivals like Venice Biennale, Munich Contemporary Dance Festival, and then Singapore Art Festival, many, many festivals in the world, when we were invited to perform our repertory company, we do this as an installation. So then the viewers will get an idea how, from these vibrant traditions, how our contemporary practices are enriching and informing themselves to go forward. I think this is very important to not to just get stuck in the outer form alone, but do an in-depth research and find out the essence, which is the concept of body and principles of movement. And this idea I would really suggest, if in India festivals, if you could think of a curated platform for contemporary work, and this curation needs some, I would like to submit that this needs some kind of in-depth knowledge. So I would like to volunteer ourselves, like for example, we were talking to Sadler's Wells, they are interested to curate a festival, you know, like from asking us whether we could do. So we are, we sent some choreographers this time to several European dance houses as part of this Dance Connect idea. Now we are planning to do it in India as well. So maybe, you know, there wasn't a major support after the independence for contemporary work, because the institutional support was not to that level where we can develop, because there needs to be some R&D and some development. So we are at a level now we can take that, and we have proven track record. So I would suggest, if you are thinking about this festival, if you're thinking about, like the gentleman suggested earlier, a contemporary aspect which is very much rooted and informed and influenced by our tradition, then we could think about developing this idea, this knowledge pool, so that we can do it properly. Thank you, sir.
You have some write-up, et cetera, then you can provide me.
If you are staying back, then we can meet tomorrow.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Dr. Y. Sadanana from Manipur. I have been associating with the Ministry of Culture since many years. I got a scholarship 1993, junior fellowship 1997, and senior fellowship in 2003. And I have been expert committee member of the Ministry of Culture many times. We met KK Mittal in different occasions, different meetings. Anyway, I have a group. The name of group is Kanlai Mime Theatre Repertory. This is Mime Theatre group. Fortunately, we visited many countries, South Korea 2 times, Armenia, Macedonia, through ICCR and our own expenses. Now, my suggestion is MIME, please kindly include in the Festival of India Abroad. MIME play is very, it is international language. We can communicate each other. So I don't think so. MIME is not, in the last Festival of India, MIME is not included. So kindly include. So we have the entertainment MIME and educative MIME plays. So we have lots of performance in India, and we can perform for the audience. So please kindly include it in the forthcoming Festival of India Abroad. And also I request the dignitaries that please, if there is possible to include the polo games. Polo games is originated from the India, means originated from the Manipur. So it is, we can perform in Australia or in the USA or Germany. They have the polo players. In London also they have polo players. So we can bring only 4 or 5 players. And the Londoner or UK or USA, they arrange the horse only. So it is not expensive. So the, like the yoga games, that we can include the polo game also in the India Festival. This is my suggestion. And I myself also presented many seminar papers in Manipur and in India. Recently, I presented one paper in, organized by the Site Academy, New Delhi, that the topic was the traditional Manipuri performing arts in making of Indian contemporary mime. So like that, I can present the papers also in MIME as well as in the traditional folk theater. So that's all to everyone.
My name is Ratnesh Mathur. Don't represent any organization. My wife and I have an interest in Indian art and architecture. We spend about 25% of our life outside India, and for the last 5 years, we are back in India. We were living in Czech Republic for about 7 years, and worked very closely with the Indian ambassadors there, 4 ambassadors, including Dr. Jaishankar. Couple of things that I've, you mentioned what is the Festival of India and how does India benefit from it. So I had a couple of suggestions there. The experience was that on the Festival of India side, the benefit is largely bilateral, and our historical links are bilateral. So even before we select artists, there seems, I have a suggestion that we should first see against each country, do a little bit of research to see what is the strong point in our culture that we stress on. For instance, in Czech Republic, I note a couple of people here who are associated with making glass. Glass industry is very big. So we have to talk about some, link between the glass industry there and Firozabad. Okay. Similarly, if we are talking of Indonesia, then we know we have strong links. If you start analyzing and doing a little research, you'll realize that the links are with Andhra Pradesh and Odisha first, right? Because the ships moved from there. So we have a Bali festival happening, Bali Yatra in Odisha historically. So by focusing on the bilateral aspect and doing a little research, we should have a grid which actually doesn't, where we try and stress. I have actually suggested there are 30 points of culture. And we, for instance, on the science aspect and on the languages aspect, India is very strong. So if we are talking of Myanmar and say Cambodia, one of the strongest things if you travel to Cambodia or Myanmar, which people have forgotten, is that although their language is not Indo-European, yet their alphabet is arranged like Kaka Gaga. Now, very simple thing which even a child in Burma or in Cambodia, actually he will relate to it in minutes, that our Kaka Gaga is equal to the Khmer Kaka Gaga, right? So these links are very important and they're documented. It's not as though we need to do original research. I mean, we already have such research available to us. My suggestion is that even before, for every festival, we select a country, there is far too much, in my experience, there's far too much stress on performing arts. And on the people front, because, there is naturally, I mean, we have a lot of talent, as you can see in the room, and there is a desire. But in my experience, like I sponsored, I was the CEO for Infosys in Europe, and the ambassador asked us to sponsor some of the artists. And we did that, because there was never a festival of India, but we had a number of, events, right? So there was a festival, like a gentleman here suggested, on Prague. There was a designer's festival. There is various festivals. Now that actually is a great opportunity for an individual performer to come there. But one time we had an experience where we sponsored and one of the greatest Bharatnatyam performances. But the audience was unprepared. There was nothing which was given to the audience explaining what is Bharatnatyam, how it relates to the dance form there. And it had to be in Czech language. You see, you had to, normally the thing is that on every seat, even before people come, a small, a printout would have helped a lot. And the artist is actually also, he's fighting for his visa all the time. This is our experience. He literally comes at the last minute and he comes in a new environment. And, the embassy is great. It helps. It helps to, and even, companies like ours, I was in an Indian company, so we sponsored a little bit. But the whole challenge is that it becomes like the stress is too much on the arts and the performing arts, and then we forget that there is a larger context, like things like language, script, very important. And historically, if you see Germany, they used to focus so much on doing research on India. But today, if you ask if we focus on the contemporary side, like a couple of people suggested, contemporary arts and not ancient India, a lot of those links are forgotten entirely. Right? So Germany has such an important link of 100, 150 years of Indology. If you don't, today nobody knows those 100 Germans who have spent their entire life researching India. Right? So somebody needs to, so that a picture of them with that right text, this involves research. And my suggestion is that, for each festival, we focus on the bilateral side. And from the Ministry of Culture, you first, in whatever is your budget, I think we can do a lot because we have a lot. But within that budget, first you decide 20% on research, 30% on air tickets, 20% on the event management. This allocation of finance, to me, is central. And because if you focus on this allocation, you have to change this allocation for each country. And also in terms of which part of I've suggested a 30-point grid of that we should cover, which should cover science aspects also. We are not zero in science. Right? So we have to stress on our strengths linked with that country, and the ministry has the onus first to do that demarcation before you select individuals who have to perform. So I think there are two aspects that we require for a festival. One is that the budget itself, you first, for each country, it should be you have to decide where is the focus. And that focus has to come from some research, and that research has to have at least 100 days in advance before you even start doing that allocation. That's my two-bit suggestion.
If you have written it out, yes, you can say.
We have to show our actual intellectual aspect of this, India's intellectual aspect. Like we have a relationship with the countries like Laos, Cambodia, mentioned, paleographic linkages. All the scripts of Southeast Asia are derived from Brahmi scripts. how Brahmi has given to given rise to other scripts like then Sinhala and even Bhutan and Tibet, Myanmar, all these scripts. And our manuscript linkages that has been depicted, and that illustrations and other things like scientific linkages, we have to rekindle this. I mean, how mathematical journey, our contribution of number system to the world, our contribution to zero, how that was migrated, how that how in Arabia that is called Hinsa, and the Western people call it that is Arabic numerals, and we call it actually that is Roman numerals here. But it is actually our contribution, and how we have contributed to the field of linguistics. As sir said, ka kha ga gha, that the place of utterances, that place of articulations, that we knew long before that Western people told us that place of articulation, that in Paninya Sikha and other Sikhas, these all things have been mentioned. We want to actually, if it is allowed, we would like to organize an exhibition of manuscripts, illustrated manuscripts, as that things have been described, that is illustrated manuscript and text-based manuscripts. And we can small workshop by which we can teach that our scripts, ancient scripts, and how these have been all the descended scripts, which have strong linkages with the countries, country specific.
नमस्कार, मेरा नाम पूर्णिमा आनंद है और मैं यहाँ पे ब्रिक्स इंटरनेशनल फोरम को रिप्रेजेंट कर रही हूँ. पिछले 25 साल से मैं रशिया, चाइना, वियतनाम, इन सब कंट्रीज़ के साथ यूथ फेस्टिवल्स ऑर्गेनाइज करती रही हूँ, और यहाँ पे मेरे कई मित्र हैं जो उन कार्यक्रमों में पार्टिसिपेट करते रहे हैं. इस पूरी चर्चा में और आप सब ने जो कोशिश शुरू की है, मैं एक बात समझ रही हूँ कि हमें दो लेवल्स पर सोचना होगा. एक तो ये कि हम भारत महोत्सव या भारत के जो कार्यक्रम करने हैं वो क्यों करें, किस देश में कब और क्यों करें, और दूसरा ये है कि उसमें क्या पेश करें जिससे भारत की एक नए भारत की तस्वीर वहाँ पे लोगों तक पहुँच सके. और दूसरा ये कि हमारे साथ हमें वहाँ पे पार्टनर ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस, हमेशा जब भी हम भारत महोत्सव करें तो वहाँ पे पार्टनर ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस को सेलेक्ट करना होगा, चाहे वहाँ की कल्चरल मिनिस्ट्रीज़ हों, चाहे हमारे एम्बेसीज़ हों, क्योंकि इस तरह के तो बहुत सारे ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैं. और यहाँ पर अभी जितने भी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बोले हैं वो इस स्तर पे बोल रहे हैं कि हम कथक की ऑर्गेनाइजेशन है, या हम योगा की ऑर्गेनाइजेशन है, या हम वैदिक कार्य कर रहे हैं. तो हम इस ये तो एक पर्टिकुलर एक काम हो गया जो एक आर्ट फॉर्म को एक हम डिस्प्ले कर रहे हैं, लेकिन जब हम भारत महोत्सव करेंगे तो हमें एक कंपोज्ड वे में जाना होगा जो कि हम भारत को पूरा वहाँ पे भारत की सॉफ्ट पावर को शोकेस कर सकें. तो उसमें हमें सिर्फ डांस ही नहीं दिखाने, हमें सिर्फ योगा नहीं दिखाना, वहाँ पर हमें फूड फेस्टिवल भी करना है, पेंटिंग कॉम्पिटिशन्स भी करने हैं, वहाँ के लोगों को भी जोड़ना है कुछ इस तरह कि वो वन टू वन जुड़ सकें. तो इसलिए हमें, मेरा ये कहना है कि हमें मिनिस्ट्री को खास तौर पे प्लानिंग लेवल पे और पॉलिसी लेवल पे सबसे पहले, क्योंकि जैसे फिनान साहब ने बोला कि हम अगर इस तरह से जो गति से काम कर रहे हैं तो हम 5-6 फेस्टिवल्स ही कर सकते हैं. तो हमें पहले ये पॉलिसी देखनी पड़ेगी कि भारत के डिप्लोमेटिक ट्रीटीज़ में कहाँ कहाँ 60 साल या 70 साल या 65 साल हो गए हैं, क्योंकि हमेशा वहाँ की कल्चरल मिनिस्ट्रीज़ यहाँ पर इंटरेस्ट लेती हैं. अगर हमारे डिप्लोमेटिक ट्रीटीज़ के 60 ईयर्स हो गए तो वो एक्सचेंज प्रोग्राम्स होते हैं. तो हमें एक तो वो लिस्ट डिप्लोमेटिक वर्क करना पड़ेगा थोड़ा सा मिनिस्ट्री को और या पार्टनर ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस को, कि हम उनको देखें कि कहाँ कहाँ पे ऐसे फेस्टिवल्स आने वाले हैं, क्योंकि उसमें हमें एक एक्सचेंज प्रोग्राम की फैसिलिटी मिलेगी और उस कंट्री का भी इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर और सपोर्ट मिलेगा. दूसरा, हमें देखना चाहिए कि हमारे राष्ट्रपति और प्रधानमंत्री कहाँ कहाँ जाने वाले हैं, उससे पहले या बाद में भारत महोत्सव होने चाहिए, क्योंकि उस वक्त लोगों के दिल में या लोगों के मानसिकता में एक बात रहती है कि भारत के प्रधानमंत्री या राष्ट्रपति हमारे देश में आए तो उसका एक इम्पैक्ट बनता है और वहाँ की गवर्नमेंट्स भी उस पर ध्यान देती हैं. तो उस दौरान हमारे फेस्टिवल्स हों, सिर्फ ये ना हो कि जब हमारा वहाँ फेस्टिवल हो तो हमारे आर्टिस्ट वहाँ कथक या भरतनाट्यम सिर्फ कर रहे हों और सिर्फ हॉल में 50 या 100 लोग हों. तो ऐसी स्थिति में भारत महोत्सव का एक जो एम होता है, कई बार ऐसे फेस्टिवल हुए हैं कि वहाँ के लोकल लोगों से पहले इंडियन लोग उठकर चले जाते हैं.
तो ऐसी स्थिति नहीं होनी चाहिए. हमें अपने महोत्सव को इस तरह से प्लान करना है कि मॉडर्न इंडिया की भी पिक्चर जाए और एशियंट इंडिया की भी पिक्चर जाए. और हमारी जो कला है, नो डाउट कि भारत की सॉफ्ट पावर बहुत पावरफुल है और उसको सही तरह से दिखाया जाना एक ज़रूरी बात है. उसके लिए हमें बहुत बार बैठना होगा, सोचना पड़ेगा और नया रोड मैप बनाना पड़ेगा, क्योंकि स्टेट कल्चरल ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस बहुत हैं, मिनिस्ट्री की भी स्टेट ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस हैं, इस तरह की आर्ट ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस भी बहुत हैं, लेकिन फेस्टिवल्स हम उस स्तर के नहीं कर पाते जिसके लिए भारत की ताकत है, जो सॉफ्ट पावर भारत की हम सही से शोकेस नहीं कर पाते. और मैं ब्रिक्स फोरम से बोल रही हूँ. एक बात मैं आपके ध्यान में लाना चाहती हूँ कि भारत की 2016 में ब्रिक्स की प्रेसिडेंसी शुरू हो रही है और हम ब्रिक्स फोरम की ओर से ये जिम्मेदारी लेने के लिए तैयार हैं कि अगर आप ब्रिक्स कंट्रीज में, ब्राज़ील, रशिया, इंडिया, चाइना और साउथ अफ्रीका में भारत महोत्सव करना चाहेंगे तो हम अपने इंटरनेशनल नेटवर्क से भी और वहाँ की ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के सपोर्ट से भी और आपके सपोर्ट से भी बहुत अच्छे फेस्टिवल कर पाएंगे. और मैं पिछले 25 साल से भारत रूस फेस्टिवल करती रही हूँ. भारत का जो यहाँ पर रूसी सांस्कृतिक केंद्र है उससे मैं जुड़ी हुई हूँ और अभी हम 22 जनवरी को रिपब्लिक डे फंक्शन कर रहे हैं, तो आप सब आमंत्रित हैं. थैंक यू.
मेरा नाम, नमस्कार, मेरा नाम फैयाज दिलबर है. मैं जिस मीडियम से हूँ उसके बारे में अभी तक कोई बात नहीं हुई यहाँ, दैट्स फिल्म. आई एम डॉक्यूमेंट्री फिल्म मेकर. फिल्म को लेकर फेस्टिवल में किस टाइप की, किस प्रकार की फिल्में हों या किन सब्जेक्ट्स को हम टच करने जा रहे हैं इसके बारे में कोई चीज़ क्लियर नहीं है अभी तक. क्या ऐसा होगा कि जो फिल्में या जिन सब्जेक्ट्स को लेकर ऑलरेडी यूट्यूब या और चैनल्स पे फिल्में हैं, अगर वैसा ही कुछ करना है तो मुझे लगता है कि वो शायद कोई हमारा मकसद पूरा नहीं करेगा. इन्होंने अभी जिक्र किया कि रिसर्च की तरफ बहुत से विदेशों में इंडियन कल्चरल आस्पेक्ट्स को लेकर रिसर्च पे काम हो रहा है. मेरी एक ही सजेशन है कि देर आर सब्जेक्ट्स जो कल्चर से पर्टेनिंग है जिनको लेके रिसर्च में बहुत स्कोप है. बहुत सारे देशों से लोग उन चीज़ों को देखने के लिए यहाँ आ जाते हैं, उन पे काम कर रहे हैं. मैं छोटी सी एक एग्जाम्पल दूंगा. देर इज़ अ ट्राइब नोन एज ड्रग पाथ, बिलीव टू बी द प्योरेस्ट एरियंस इन द वर्ल्ड. बटालिक सेक्टर में है, करगिल सेक्टर में. तो बहुत खूबसूरत ट्राइब है. जर्मनी और पता नहीं कितने देशों से आज तक पिछले 10-20 साल में लोग आते रहे, उन पे काम होता रहा, लेकिन हम उनको उतना एक्सपोजर नहीं दे पाए. बहुत पॉजिटिव सेंस की का ट्राइब है, वो बहुत पॉजिटिविटी है उसमें. अभी तक वो रिटेन कर पाए हैं अपने कल्चरल हेरिटेज को और अपने रिचुअल्स को. अभी तक प्योरेस्ट आर्यन रेस में मानी जाती है दुनिया में. मेरे हिसाब से हमें इन एस्पेक्ट्स को फिल्मों में इनकॉर्पोरेट करना चाहिए. थैंक यू वेरी मच.
There's a belt known as Drogyun, which is in the Batalik sector of Ladakh. There are 5 lakes,
Da, Honu, Darchik, Urdas and Bima, जहाँ पर वो लोग रहते हैं. बहुत खूबसूरत ट्राइब है, बहुत नीट एंड क्लीन ट्राइब है. दे आर ऑलवेज वेयरिंग फ्लावर्स ऑन देयर हेड गियर्स थ्रू आउट ईयर. बहुत कलरफुल ट्राइब है और उन पे मेरे हिसाब से काम करने की बहुत ज़रूरत है. एग्जैक्टली, मतलब जहाँ तक जो मैंने इस पर रिसर्च करी, आई हैव डन अ फिल्म ऑन दिस ट्राइब. तो रिसर्च के दौरान मुझे पता चला कि बहुत सारे जर्मन्स आए, उन्होंने किताबें लिखी जर्मन लैंग्वेज में इन पे, लेकिन अनफॉर्चुनेटली यहाँ से हम रह गए. अच्छा, एक खुशी की बात यह है कि अर्लियर वो बेल्ट जो है वो डिफेंस मिनिस्ट्री के कुछ रीजंस की वजह से इट वॉज रेस्ट्रिक्टेड एरिया. इनिशियली 2 विलेजेस खोले गए फॉर आउटसाइडर्स, बट इन 2010 5 के 5 विलेज आउटसाइडर्स के लिए खोले गए हैं और आज भी टूरिस्ट विदेश से आते हैं. मेरा यह मानना है कि टूरिस्ट जब वहां आ जाते हैं उनको खोजने के लिए, हम यहां से फेस्टिवल में उनको लेके क्यों ना जाएं एक फिल्म की सूरत में. दैट्स माय पॉइंट. थैंक यू वेरी मच.
नमस्कार, आई एम सीरत नरेंद्रा. आई एम अ डिजाइनर एंड आर्टिस्ट बाय प्रोफेशन एंड आई एम ऑल्सो बीन इन टू प्रोडक्शन एंड डायरेक्शन ऑफ मल्टीमीडिया पेजेंट्स. Lot of very valid points have been already made by these all the talented teams here. Now, one thing I really want to mention. Now, I've been working in the field of art, design, and culture for more than 30 years. I trained in Italy as a designer. I've got 3 degrees in art and design. I chose to come back and work in my own country. But we really need to bring in professionalism in every respect, right from the organization planning up to the presentation stage. हम लोग, आई हैव सीन पीपल, सम ऑफ द सीनियर मोस्ट आर्टिस्ट स्टेज पे जाके क्रम्पल्ड क्लोथ्स, this kind of ishara karoing, which looks so unprofessional to the musicians. And things, these are small things. Similarly, in the planning organization says, we have to, if we have to compete the world, we have to come across in a professional manner in every respect. You know, I have worked at the grassroots level. I have worked in the villages. I worked with the tribals. For 3 years, I worked in Maharashtra, who were the earthquake victims, Banjara tribes, using art as the medium to rehabilitate. And then we, the 3 years' work, we brought together, in brought up to Delhi, and it was showcased at Siri Fort in a multimedia presentations, using various forms of visual and performing arts to convey the story of revival of hope. Now, art, India is so rich, so beautiful, we are talented. There's no dearth of talent that we have, but we need professionalism. And yet, even if we want to try and bring professionalism, we lack support from the system. You know, even very minor thing I would mention. Now, that's something personally I've been facing. I've worked for 35 years. I've designed costumes for the Commonwealth Games opening ceremony. I've been designing ambience for Suraj Kund Mela for the last 4 years. Working with 100 artisans at a time, working day and night, putting showcasing work. I've designed ambience, street decor, etc. installations at Europalia India Festival in Belgium, with 200 artisans, with artisans working some in Orissa, Maharashtra, Delhi, UP, different areas. But the moment we go to Sangeet Natak Academy or ICCR for empanelment, simple thing like empanelment, forget about giving a project. When they hand you the form, there is no column for any other artist. Dancers hai, musicians hai, compere hai, and vocal artists, instrumentalists, that's it. There is no column. It does not exist. So I would request that, you know, are there many artists, I'm sure, who would benefit if you have multimedia, multidimensional arts to at least to empanel them and then see the work. You know, we have ideas. We have a lot of very fascinating ideas. I totally agree with the lady here who said we need to have theme-based thing, not just in isolation. We can plan such panoramic stuff to represent India in a grand manner. That's what we need to do. If we want respect, we have to give our respect to ourselves first. And we do it in a professional manner. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Janvi, and I'm a Bharatanatyam dancer. I am the Shishya of Dr. Guru Saroja Vaidyanathan. I just have a very small point to make, like very senior artists over here. And please, no offenses. If we bring in only the gradation or the awards and, you know, give artists weightage on that and, you know, give them opportunities in festivals organized by ICCR, generally what happens is very young artists, because it takes a great deal of hard work and a lot of years you have to put into your art to get up to a level to get a Padma award or, you know, any other highly acclaimed award. So young artists, they generally don't get an opportunity, and they have to reach the age of 45-50 to actually first get an award and then get an opportunity. So I would request that if there is some way where a system can be designed that even young artists, though I've recently got a Doordarshan gradation, but I have got it after so many years of, you know, hard work, and at various levels I have faced I don't know if this is the right word, but there has been a bias or a partiality, because there are a lot of people who would push certain people up so that they get the gradation before the other really deserving people get it, because they may have a cultural heritage or a lineage because of which they get that kind of, you know, support or a push. So artists like us who come from a very, you know, middle class family, who do not have any backup or support apart from their parents and, you know, the guru at the very, as the last resort to look up to, that if nobody is pushing us, we go and request our gurus, and if they can get us an opportunity, that's how we get it. Otherwise, as individuals, it's very difficult for us to push ourselves up. I'm also training about 100 students. I have my own dance school. But if we go out to get opportunities, we are always pushed on, because there are already a lot of senior people who are established, who've already got that opportunity. So some system has to come for artists, young artists.
We are aware of this problem, and our motto is to identify the talent and to at least strive to ensure that no talent is allowed to go waste. And we are aware of the problem, and therefore, in the grading formula, whatever is evolved, you will find a good mix of upcoming and budding artists and established artists. Okay, I think we had enough of discussions. It is 5:30, I have some other meeting. But please do send me your suggestions. And after those suggestions, whenever we crystallize something, perhaps we'll either put it on the web or we will convene another meeting so that we crystallize, we finalize, and move forward.
Excuse me, sir. Thank please you. Listen to me. Actually, the
this
thing is...
This will be the last intervention.
Yeah, yeah. It will be very brief. I am Dr. Ramani Giri and disciple of Dr. Nataraj Ramakrishna from Hyderabad. And I am an Andhranatyam dancer. Why I wanted to speak in this regard is already nationally recognized dance forms. You know all Bharatanatyam, Kuchipudi, Kathak, all the other forms. They are already getting recognition in very many festivals. I am in Delhi for the last 20 years and teaching Andhranatyam. It has been recognized as other traditional dance forms of India by Sangeetanatak Academy. Because I am based in Delhi, because my husband is working in Home Ministry as Joint Secretary. I am teaching dance in Delhi. But unfortunate thing is, sir, the required encouragement for Andhranatyam, the ancient traditional dance form of Andhra Pradesh, which has been already recognized as other traditional form of classical dance from Sangeetanatak Academy, is not getting due recognition. I don't know whether in festivals or locally also. I'm not asking encouragement for myself, because I already received junior research fellowship and research from culture also, and I performed in Doordarshan also. For my students, I'm teaching for the last 20 years in Delhi, Andhranatyam. But like she said, the recognition level is very less compared to other dance forms. I'm not only talking about Andhranatyam, there are other dance forms like traditional dance forms, Ravindranatyam, I know, the Bengal se hai, or Gaudiya Nutya from Bengal, and also Kerala Natyam. There are many other traditional dance forms which were recognized by Sangeetanatak Academy, are there very rich in tradition, Indian tradition. So I wanted to request, very humble request is to, from next time onwards, when you plan out for a program outside, to add some lecture demonstrations and also some performances of other traditional dance forms of India, sir. Mine is Andhranatyam. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Before we proceed for a cup of tea, I'd just like to say that information, all this whole procedure, will be put up on the ministry's website and will be constantly updated. So as and when things develop, things happen, it'll be put up on the website. The website, if you'd like to note, is www.indiaculture.nic.in. And in case anybody wishes to be in touch with us in any way for any queries or any suggestions, they can send in their requests or their suggestions to our foicel-culture@gov.in. I'll repeat that. FOICEL, which is short for Festival of India, foicel-culture@gov.in. May I request all of you to proceed for a cup of tea, please. Thank you very much.